Plants need light. They arrange their leaves to capture a maximum of sunlight. What happens when their access to light is blocked? The leaf angle changes to avoid shading. This is an important part of the shade avoidance response, which is performed by almost all land plants. As part of this response, a signal has to move from the leaf tip to the petiole, because that is where the leaf angle is controlled. And we already know the signal. It is the plant hormone auxin, one of the most important signaling molecules in plants. So how does auxin move cell to cell from the leaf tip to the petiole? What has been postulated so far is a transporter-mediated movement. Auxin transporters with polarized localization in the plasma membrane facilitate auxin efflux and auxin uptake into the downstream cell. There's good evidence for these transporters having an essential role in the shading response, mainly stemming from mutant plants that lack these uptake transporters. These show almost no shading response. But what we found out in our study is that the shading response does not only depend on auxin transporters, but also on auxin movement through plasmodesmata. Plasmodesmata are membrane-lined channels in the cell wall that connect the cytoplasm of neighboring plant cells. Small molecules such as auxin can diffuse through plasmodesmata according to their concentration gradient. And what we found is that the plasmodesmata in certain cells of the leaf create a diffusion highway for the movement of auxin from leaf tip to petiole. When we look at the cells on the lower side of the leaf, the epidermis, then we see that most of the cells have a shape like a puzzle piece. However, above the midrib and petiole, cells are strongly elongated. We used confocal microscopy to photoactivate a small fluorescent dye very similar in size to auxin in one of these puzzle piece-like cells and saw that the activated dye spreads to neighboring cells, more or less the same in all directions. When we did the same on these elongated cells, then we observed a spread primarily in the longitudinal direction. This is quite remarkable because it has not been previously recognized that the plasmodesmata within a single cell can be differentially regulated. Based on the data from the photoactivation experiments, we calculated effective permeabilities for auxin, which reflect the much higher diffusive capacity along the elongated cells than across these cells. Moreover, we identified a mutant plant lacking a protein with a role in plasmodesmata permeability regulation, which has a similar diffusivity in longitudinal direction, but also high diffusivity in the transverse direction. Compared to wild-type plants, these mutants had a delayed and reduced shading response. And when we applied a drop of radioactive auxin to the leaf tip and measured the arrival of signal at the petiole, we could see that auxin moved faster in wild-type leaves than in mutant leaves of the same size. This proves that the channeling effect created by the anisotropic permeability of these elongated cells is important for auxin transport from leaf tip to petiole. Future research must establish how the plasmodesmata-mediated and transporter-mediated auxin movement are coordinated, as well as investigate if such a diffusion directionality also affects the movement of other small molecules, for example, defense compounds. Please find further information in our paper that appeared in Current Biology, Volume 30.